In so many ways, Henry Ford was a simple man. He liked to go camping with his friends. That's Thomas Edison behind him. He enjoyed old-time country dancing. Here he is with Burroughs, the naturalist, skating with his grandchildren. They plant a garden together, Henry Ford II and Benson. His first car, he called it a quadricycle. That's his wife, Clara. He began with an idea that most people thought wouldn't work, but he made it work. And the tools he used were common sense, ingenuity, and perseverance, along with a natural instinct for knowing how to put machines together and make them run. He was born into a world of limited horizons, and though he left the farm that might have been his heritage, he never lost his love for the land and the everlasting cycle of seed time and harvest. What he accomplished helped men put the burden of work on machines and broke the barriers of space and time, of isolation and distance. His life was a paradox. While his mechanical genius helped to change forever the lives of people everywhere, he sought to preserve in some permanent form a record of the world around him and his ever-widening interest in it. He collected buildings the way others collect stamps and put them in a village where time stands still. He assembled acres of machines and put them under cover in a vast historical museum. And early, he discovered the astonishing capacity of the motion picture camera to document for all time whatever it saw when the crank was turned. In April 1914, at his Highland Park plant, he organized a motion picture department which through the years produced films that were shown in theaters and schools throughout the country. Travelogues, newsreels, and documentaries that touched on nearly every facet of American life.